Welcome back inside Rexall Place as we get set for the second of three meetings between the Edmonton Oilers and the Dallas Stars. Let's meet the starting goaltenders, brought to you by Tim Hortons Premium Blend Coffee. It's always 20 minutes fresh. Devan Dubnyk made 39 saves in Columbus Sunday for his fifth win of the season. He was the game's first star. And at the other end, 29-year-old Kari Lehtinen, second in the league in wins. He has won his last four starts, including February 6th. It was here at Rexall Place. These two teams, as I mentioned, will play three times in the month of February. All three in February. Two of them here at Rexall, February 28th. The Oilers, as part of that long Briar road trip, will be in Dallas. And Louis, what we're seeing here is what we have seen all season. It is Ralph Krueger not afraid to put his top line out there against the top line of the opposition, and they have a heck of a top line.
They certainly do, and both these teams have very strong first line, so a good little test here for Ryan Nugent, Hopkins, Hall, and Everly going up against the very hot line of Dallas. Ben, Jaromir Jagr, and Brendan Morrow should be a good battle.
Dallas comes in having won three games in a row, including Friday against Anaheim. They won that game 3-1. The Oilers, of course, won 3-1 on Sunday in Columbus. Jaromir Jagr, the hero, the last time these teams met, won the game in overtime. Jamie Benn. Schultz and Schultz out there to try and stop that top line as Taylor Hall picks up the puck and avoids a big hit from Goligoski. Goligoski did not play the last time these teams met as Taylor Hall goes down hard. Larson in the lineup along with Goligoski, sent him down. Larson, number 36. He didn't grasp against Anaheim. And Louis, I know you know this. He is one of only seven Danes to ever play in the National Hockey League.
Tell you what, there's more and more every year.
Antoine Roussel not playing. He's one of eight guys from France. As we take a look at the keys to the game, brought to you by the 2013 Ford Super Duty. It's built for tough.
Well, for the Dallas Stars tonight, good start. This is a team that when they get off to a good start, score the first goal of the game. They've won five of their six games doing just that. They want to do the same tonight versus this young Oilers team. And against, for Edmonton, against this Dallas Stars team, get physical. I don't mean Olivia Newton-John's song from back in the 80s. Start dancing. Finish your checks. Get physical. Make it a tough night for the opposition.
Top two goal-getters on the Oilers team are on the ice right now. And Alex Hemsky and Mail Yakupov, centered by Sam Gagner. Hemsky and Yakupov each with five goals. Gagner with the puck now. Moving in against Trevor Daly. Gets turned around. Back the other way comes Derek Roy. Roy trying to get by Schmid. Schmid and Potter together on the blue line. Jeff Petrie will play with Mark Fistrick. As we mentioned off the top of the show, Mark Fistrick playing against his old team for the first time in his career. Speaking of the lineups, let's take a look at them now. Brought to you by Boston Pizza, your hockey headquarters destination, Louis. Of course, the big news is that Ryan Smith is not in the lineup.
For the Edmonton Oilers, is young Chris Vandervelde up for it, but also Goldson's made a couple changes to his lineup as well. Big Jamie Oleksiak, the big 6'7" first rounder from a couple of years ago, is out. As you mentioned, Larson goes in, and Ryan Garbutt will be on the fourth line on the right-hand side for them. So trying to get some fresh legs in this game tonight. They played tomorrow night in Calgary, so they want to put some more fresh bodies back in the lineup there. He was talking about the shortened season. You're going to see that a lot.
Eric Belange back in the lineup, and a nice hit by Mark Fistrick. And Thomas Vinsuer felt the wrath of number 45 right up the middle. Here comes Cody Egan, a breakaway, stopped by Dubnyk. Devan Dubnyk keeps this a 0-0 game. And that's the risk-reward, Lou, I guess, when you go for the big hit.
Absolutely, and you know what, for Cody Egan, came over in that trade for Mike Ribeiro from Washington, just a burst of speed up the middle, and a terrific save by Dubnyk.
Egan without a goal in his last 15, and Devan Dubnyk keeps that way. Here's a steal. Garbutt trying to get a shot away. Can't do it. Ben Eager quickly back the other way. He'll chip it. Chasing himself. Out there with Petrell and Chris Vandervelde. Vandervelde sit down. He played against Detroit. Did not play against Columbus. He's in the lineup tonight. Vandervelde, number 54, keeps it in at the blue line. Leonard Petrell will give it to Vandervelde. Vandervelde being watched by Vern Fiddler. Nystrom bounces it off the boards and sends it the length of the ice, going back to get it. And touch it up is Nick Schultz.
Good pressure there by Schultz to pinch down that wall and keep a puck in and also force the icing. Mark Fistrick, we talked about it, 6 years he spent in Dallas before coming over to Edmonton this year. Big hit early on as he catches Thomas Vinsuer with his head down. And then right here, a terrific pass up the ice to a speeding Cody Eakin, and he tries to go low on Devin Dubnyk. He gets down and sticks that pad out and makes a save.
Pittsburgh had 6 hits in that game against the Columbus Blue Jackets, so now he's got 24 on the season. And Jim, this is just his 7th game in an Oilers uniform.
Well, he said he wasn't going to pull any punches against his old mates, and I guess he wasn't kidding. I mean, Vinsor's only been there for a little while, but still.
Get it done early, get involved. Schultz trying to keep it in against Garbutt, can't do it. Ooh, goes right on.
Everly and Hall just collided
wow.
Right there, broke Hall's
broken stick. Well, those guys did that on the stairs, and it cut Hall up just before the season started. J.D. Benn keeps that puck in, rims around, waiting for it there is Yager. He'll leave it for Brendan Morrow, trying to get it back to him. On the other side, it's Jordan Eberle. Eberle pushes it ahead for Hall. Taylor Hall down the right side. Hall trying to get around Aaron Rome. Those two come behind the net. Here is Hall. To Eberle. Eberle. Trying to get by Ben. He'll play it behind the net for Hall. Hall being watched by Jamie Benn. Taylor Hall. Back to the point. Schultz through traffic, and this time it doesn't get through. That's a rarity for him. Able to keep it in, though. Centering pass. Hall fires a shot right on. Letting in the save. He faked the pass to Eberle and fired the puck towards the net. Played good pressure in the offensive zone for that top line of Edmonton. All from a little chip by Taylor Hall. The blue line get it. Deep cycle it down low. Derek Roy's shot is blocked by the shot block leader on this Edmonton Oilers team, Ladislav Schmid. He's got 33 blocks now.
Well, a little mishap before the on the start of that shift for the top line early on. As you watch Eberle and Hall going through the middle here, they're both looking at the puck in the offensive zone. Shatters the stick at Taylor Hall. He goes and gets a new one. And I love this little play by him here. Instead of trying to walk through that defender, hold on to that puck. He chips it in, gets his own little chip, and they establish a real nice cycle in the offensive zone and generate a couple chances. Looks like Michael Ryder's going to head to the box 2 minutes from that last play as well.
Too many men on the ice for the Dallas Stars. And the Oilers go to the power play. For the first time in this game, they were 0-for-4 in Columbus. 4 power play chances. The last time these teams met, the Oilers were 1-for-4. From the faceoff, Potter will get it to Yakupov. Yakupov fires that shot through traffic of PRV, providing the screen. Back to the point it comes. Potter waiting for it. Gagne is the other guy on the blue line. Hamsky takes his time. He'll give it to Magnus Bjarvi. Bjarvi with a game-winning goal shorthanded. Fires it through. Here's Gagne. Gagne looks for Hamsky. Gets by him. That's Yakupov. Here's Gagne. Gagne looks for Yakupov. Plays it back to the point instead. Potter's got it. Potter to Yakupov. Yakupov quick pass to Gagne. Gagne takes the shot. Goes down low for Hamsky. Hamsky's got options. And he goes to Yakupov. And he swung and missed. 1:12 to go in the man advantage. Hamsky to Yakupov. Nail Yakupov back for Hamsky. Comes around to Gagne. Gagne will give it to Hamsky. Alex Hamsky walking in. Gagne's got it down. Gagne looks across the ice. And there it gets caught up in Lettinen as he stepped out and prevented that pass from getting through.
Real good mobility on this power play. And something Ralph Krueger talked to us about this morning, Kevin, is that he wants his players moving, getting to position, making a little more of an active play. Aleš Hemský all over the ice in this power play right here. He sets up, finds Yakupov back door, who just can't get a handle on it. So a very good power play to start this game. You look at Yakupov, he's a shooter. He loves to score goals, likes to celebrate as well.
And had a near miss there. Didn't get a point in Columbus only 4 times this season. Nail Yakupov has been held off the score sheet. Tied for first among rookies in goals with those 5. 42 seconds left to go in the man advantage. Hall with Hartikainen in front. Hall driving for the net. Has to jam it home. Trevor Daly picks it up and he can't get it out. Good play to keep it in for Justin Schultz. Aaron Rome gets surrounded. Eugene Hopkins given a bump there by Derek Roy. They joust for the puck. It's still alive. Now it comes around the near side, racing over to get to it to Jordan Eberle ahead of Louis Erickson. Cross-ice pass is broken up by Derek Roy. Justin Schultz keeps it in. Hall, quick pass for Eberle, but it went off his skate. And that allows the Stars to get it out. The Stars, the fifth best penalty killers on the road, are successful in their first penalty kill. 13:43 to go here in the first period. Eager. Petrel and Belanger. Eric Belanger playing with two broken toes. Ben to Mora. Mora looking across the ice. Trying to find Goligoski. Ends up behind the net. Now Jágr from the corner. Centering pass. Picked off. Ben Eager. Chips it in. He'll go after it himself along with Petrel. Petrel given up there by Goligoski. Morrow in there to help out. The puck comes back to the point. Fiskrick's shot is steered aside. Lettinen sends it into the netting. No score here at Rexall Place. Tell us Oilers hockey on Sportsnet.
Taylor Hall, Jordan Eberle, and the rest of the Oilers disappointed. They didn't score on their first power play of the evening. Talked about prior to the break that Ralph Kruger spoke to you about, and he also spoke to his players about as they casually worked through it this morning, looking at different options as each one getting a chance, whether it's from the half boards or sometimes shots from the point. And even though they're fifth in the league in this category, Louis, didn't stop the Oilers from trying to work out some of the kinks.
Yeah, no question about it. Only three power play goals in their last six games played for Edmonton. So for Ralph Kruger, wanting to go over a couple of the little details. And as I mentioned earlier, and what Gene was talking about, that little bit more mobility, a little bit more moving by the players, getting into lanes, freeing up some seam plays to open up. And we saw a little bit of there in both power play units. A lot much better than it was in Columbus last game.
They were 0-4 in that game against Columbus. And another big hit, this time turned in by Sam Gagner, as he absolutely flattened Philip Larson.
And that's one thing that Ralph Kruger talked about. You don't have to be big to be physical. He's not talking about glass-breaking hits. He's talking about finishing checks, getting in the grill of the opponent, making it a tough night. You saw Sam Gagner right there with a good finish. It goes a long way, and it's contagious.
Sometimes when Olivia Newton-John just pops into your head, they're getting physical, and a penalty coming up. And it's going to be a cross-checking call against the rookie.
It's the legendary stubby pencil, one of many used to win a total of $7 million last year. Amazing.
Get your game on with Pools.
Sam Gagner looks on here, a penalty coming up to Jakpop. But here's that hit as he gets in the forecheck, good finish right there. And you can see Larson wasn't even expecting that hit right here. Jakpop, as we said, it's contagious, maybe a little bit too aggressive with the stick there as he catches the lower back area, and he'll head to the box. 2 minutes for cross-check.
Dallas was 2-for-5 in their victory against Anaheim. 1-for-3 in the game against Edmonton on February 6th. Riley Smith drops it down low. Picked up there by Louis Erickson. Erickson is it back to Smith, to the middle to Ryder, trying to bang a puck through, but he couldn't get it through Leonard Petrel. Petrel up front with Belanger. Jeff Petrie and Nick Schultz of the blue line. Smith centering pass. Belanger broke that up, comes back to the point. Derek Roy waiting for it there. Derek Roy to Trevor Daly. Daly back to Roy. One times that shot. It goes right to Ryder. He gets knocked down as he put a backhand through. Now the puck sits for Smith. Belanger had lost his stick. He got it back again. Got it out. The Oilers can change up. Vandeville, he hops over the boards as Roy gets surrounded. Erickson carries on. Louis Erickson. Ben looking for the puck. Back to the point it comes. Trevor Daly moves to the middle. Gives it to Derek Roy. Roy to Daly. Daly right back to Roy. Walks in. Shot blocked. Another chance. Stopped by Dubnyk. Ryder to Erickson. He's got Ben in front. Louis Erickson checked by Schmid. The puck comes free, and it's fired off the glass and down the ice.
A little aggressive penalty kill. Good puck movement by Dallas as well to move that thing around, find lanes. A little sharp angle shot on Dubnyk before it squeezes through the pads.
It's amazing to think with Dallas, with all the talents that they've got, they've got the two power play goals on the road this season. Power play's been better for them the last couple of games, though, but it was really struggling there. The 94th, no power play goals for, but they have three in their last two games played, so starting to dial that thing in. Jaromir Jágr takes a look, 10 seconds to go, delivers down low for Ben. He's got Morrow in front. Ben tried to slide it through to Jágr. He missed. There's Goligoski's shot. Morrow looking for the rebound. Can't get it home. As Devin Dubnyk got the pad down, and then everybody collapsed. The penalty is over. Yakupov's back on the ice. Mark Bistrick making his presence felt. Centering pass for Morrow. Just missed. Goligoski keeps it in. 5-on-5. Pressure still as Jágr, though, can't control that pass. And it'll come out to center. The Oilers get their big line right back on the ice. Jagr circles the net. Nearly Jagr centering pass. Everly got just enough to disrupt Cody Eakin.
But that was going to be right on the tape. A little needle threaded by Jagr to Eakin, and Everly just breaks it up with a little tip of the stick.
Dallas got three shots on that power play. Nugent-Hopkins shot. Everly settles it down. A backhand goes wide. Tanner Hall with it now. Good pace to this game. Brendan Morrow picks it up, wants to relieve the pressure, sends it down the ice. Thomas Ventura racing after it, but getting there first was Justin Schultz. 6-4, the shots favor the Dallas Stars. Tanner Hall moving in, the puck comes to Kari Lehtinen. He's not going to take any chances. He will hang on to it.
Wise decision there by Lehtinen to freeze that puck up.
Brendan Morrow, one goal on the season, tries to get a little soccer going to kick it in. Stopped.
Well, as mentioned by Kevin, Eric Belanger is playing with a couple of broken toes, and he is on the ice thanks to some help from head equipment manager Jeff Lang. It was Jeff not trying once, twice, but three times to make sure he got the proper protection onto the skate of Eric Belanger. It's made of sand split. You heat it up, then you can mold it, and then it hardens on the skate, and it's drilled right into the skate. So Jeff, along with Eric, working together to toe that party line.
Off, race for it. Sharp angle shot by Garbutt, comes all around the near side. Vern Fiddler keeps it in. Vern Fiddler wanted to send out a shout to his dad Bob, living in Edmonton, watching his son right now. Nystrom took that feed. Stopped by Devin Dubnyk. What a pass from Yakupov to Kempski. Big rebound. And picked up by Dillon. Brendan Dillon. Drop pass for Nystrom with a wrist shot through traffic, and that was blocked by Petrie. The Oilers came into this game fourth in the league in blocked shots. Leonard Petrell trying to get away from Derek Roy. He'll lead the charge with Chris Vandevelde and Ben Eager. Fires it into the corner. Eager going after it. Against Ryder. Stick lifted. Back the other way comes Louis Erickson. Erickson across the blue line. Erickson goes it towards the net. Devin Dubnyk makes the save, and he'll hang on to it.
Game starting to open up a little bit here. Both teams getting their feet going, and a couple power plays to boot for each. And Neil Yakupov, a nice little nifty behind the back pass there, right there, playing on the right hand side. Going to be on your backhand a little bit, and he just knows exactly where Hemsky's going to be. Hemsky eventually gets a pretty good shot away from a wide angle.
So, Louis, when you were a rookie, you made plays like that?
Not a chance. Wow. I would have ended up right on the opposition's tape in the back of the net. And then I would have been up here with you again.
It's not that bad, is it?
It's not that bad.
But that kid's got some confidence, though.
Yeah, you know what? And that's going to come with time. You know, that's obviously something he's working on, and something that I don't think that people really realize that he was as good as he is passing. He likes to pass the puck. It's off the stick in a hurry. And that's one of the things that the coaching staff really likes about his game, is that he makes that decision quickly to get the puck to somebody that's open.
Justin
had a good chance earlier.
Jumping in to keep the puck alive. Hartikainen behind the net. Hartikainen pushes it to the corner. Mäkisjärvi squeezed off the puck, but there is Belanger. Puck goes straight up in the air. And when it comes down, Jamie Benn gets it out. And that was knocked down by the high stick of Justin Schultz. Gene.
Well, time to play Safeway's $1 million score and win. If any Oilers player scores 5 goals in tonight's game, Sharon, no relation to Corey Potter of Edmonton, could win $1 million shopping swipe at Safeway, and you could be our next lucky winner right here on Sportsnet West.
Well, Mäkisjärvi scored his first goal of the season last game versus the Columbus Blue Jackets. I thought this should have been interference right here on Brendan Morrow, who made no attempt on the puck whatsoever. Shoulder to the chest of Piarvi didn't allow him to get that puck. He got away with one there, as they've been calling that a lot this year. But for Piarvi, getting his feet moving, that goal he scored last game, the game-winning goal, can really bolster your confidence, and he's got his wheels tonight.
Hall slips up, gets up, keeps the puck back to the point. Speed shot. Hall gets to it. Hall for Eberle. Nugent Hopkins is out in front. Hall with the puck in the near side. Schmied keeps it in. Eberle gives it right back to Ladislav Schmied. He'll give it to Nugent Hopkins. Back up top for Eberle. But it's cut off. And Ryder starts away. He'll give it to Erickson. Erickson to Roy. Eric Roy. Ryder throwing his weight around. Hit Eberle as Hall comes back against Dillon. He'll go wide on Robidon. Scores! Taylor Hall snaps that shot home. It's 1-0 Edmonton.
Well, I'll tell you what, Kevin, that's what happens when you shoot the puck. Great shot by Taylor Hall here. And they're starting to get it here by getting the puck to net. We've seen a couple wide-angle shots. Good transition. Back check by Eberle around the boards. And for Taylor Hall, he's just getting this puck up the ice. He says, why not? Put it to the net. He's got that good release. And he handcuffs Letton here as he just gets it. A low, hard shot across the grain. And it finds the back of the net off the post. A 1-0 lead for Edmonton. And for Taylor Hall, first goal in a while for him. And it's a big one.
First goal in the month of February for Taylor Hall, given 3 on the season. And 3 points in his last 4 games. Jordan Eberle picks up the assist. Eberle's got 6 on the season. 12:59, the time of the opening goal for the Edmonton Oilers. And they do it with their 6th shot of the period. Hill coming is Yakupov. Letton the save. All the way back to the point. Mark Bistrick waiting for it there. He'll give it to Jeff Petrie. Petrie centering pass. Yakupov dancing in. Backhand. Letton the save. Well, Corey Roach of Stony Plain entered the score and win and has won the Lagostina 11-piece cookware set courtesy of Safeway and Tostitos Tortilla Chips and Tater Hall.
Another good opportunity. Good follow-up shift by the second line of Edmonton to get into the offensive zone. Beautiful pass by Petrie. And look at the move by Yakupov. Knows that he can't get a shot through. Goes to the backhand. Quickly gets it through. And Kari Lehtinen was up to the task for that one there. But you like to see that confidence of Yakupov making that move in the slot zone. Not trying to bury that puck through a bunch of people. Finds an open lane and gets it there.
Takes off one by Vandevelde as the Vandevelde Eager Petrel line out there now. Van Eager. He has got the speed to get to those hits. Aaron Rome. Given a bump by Vandevelde as the puck comes all the way down the ice. Icing waved off. Garbutt prevented that. His backhand stopped by Dubnyk. He's going to cover it up with Nystrom right on the doorstep. Taylor Hall celebrating his 3rd goal of the season. The Oilers with a 1-0 lead here at the Rex.
It's time now to play the Telus game of fan right, fan wrong. The scenario, a handmade jersey. Now, is this a fan right or a fan wrong? Enter for your chance to win an Optik TV and Samsung prize package valued at $13,000 or tickets to an upcoming Oilers home game. All you have to do is text Oilers to 333-777 or visit telus.com/hockey. For every completed entry, Telus will donate $1 to Heroes Hockey, helping at-risk youth play Canada's game.
If you're going to do it, just don't put that much paint on your brush.
Yeah, at least do a good job. Right?
Absolutely. Now, did you have a Dino Cicerelli when you were in London playing for the Knights? He was
no,
a hero.
I didn't, but he was one of the guys that I obviously looked up to and watched his career. Had a terrific career. And was one of those great little guys you didn't see a whole lot of back then that could put the puck in the net, would go to those tough areas, and wasn't afraid to give you the stick from time to time, too.
Magnus Bjarvi backhands it in. Goligoski will get there first, and there's a hit from Eric Bélanger. 5:40 to go in the first period. The Oilers with a 1-0 lead. Taylor Hall and Jordan Eberle combining at 12:59. Timo Hartikainen, Eric Bélanger, Magnus Bjarvi. Hartikainen softly dumps that puck in as that line wants to change up. Ralph Kruger wants to get his top line back on the ice. Because the top line for the Dallas Stars is out there right now. Eberle with the steal. Goligoski takes him into the boards. Larson will go over and get the puck, and he'll get it to Goligoski. Derek Roy. Flips that high, and instead of getting to Jagr, it goes right into the Oiler bench.
Now everybody knows that we used a sperm donor.
You're lesbians. I think your secret's out.
City's new comedy Seed has joined Monday's blockbuster comedy night, which is the most watched night of the week. That's Seed on City Monday.
First of 5 games at home for the Edmonton Oilers before they go on that long Brier road trip. So the Oilers trying to make some hay here. 2-1-2. as Yakupov plays a little center field here.
Yeah, he does. Made a nice catch. Throws it back on the ice. I think the fan behind the bench is like, hey, yeah, I'll take that.
That's another rookie mistake, right?
Yeah, give it to the fans. But it's nice to see that he's got his head up on the bench and he's paying attention, watching the shift in front of him. And you never know what's going to come flying over that bench.
High sticking call for Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. And the coincidental minors, the call, as he and Aaron Rome got tangled up.
Right off the draw here as Ryan Nugent-Hopkins tries to go through and get in onto the puck. He gets his stick up into the face area of Aaron Rome. You can see it come up there, and I guess there was an interference call because he was stepping into the way of Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, not allowing him to go through. So he's going to be called for interference, Rome is, and then because the stick came up and caught him, he got nailed too.
And with the way the Oilers have started this game, 4-on-4 hockey kind of plays into their favor with the way Taylor Hall is skating right now.
Yeah, he's got his wheels for sure tonight. You know, one of the things that Dallas wanted to try and concentrate on was limiting those fast breaks by Edmonton playing in the offensive zone, wearing them down in the cycle. And when this game opens up, you can just see it start to develop for Edmonton, where they seem to have the faster, stronger team in that regard. Dallas is a team that if you allow them to get in there and set up, they can do some work down low. That's for sure.
Here comes Taylor Hall trying to get around Goligoski. It's tied up. Louis Erickson picks it up. He is checked by Belanger. So Legoski gets it one more time. Now the Stars can't get out of that corner. Philip Larson hammered earlier in the period by Sam Gagne. As Louis Erickson, long time Dallas Star. Derek Roy, his shot goes wide. Comes to the near side, picked up by Eberle. Jordan Eberle starts away with Sam Gagne. Eberle going wide, driving for the net. Bailey was all over it. Ben will give it to Erickson. Erickson, the most goals of any Dallas Star since the 2006-2007 season. He's popped in 142. He's got four on this season. He and Jamie Benn tied for the lead in that department.
Nice to see Jordan Eberle drive that puck wide once again. He got popped pretty hard by Jack Johnson last game, but you know what? A guy that wants to score goals, he'll go right back to what he does best, driving that puck to the net.
Jamie Benn on a giveaway, and then recovery by Ladislav Schmid. Jagr against his fellow countryman Schmid. Pass intercepted, and then turning is Alex Hemsky. Hemsky avoids the check from the check. Goligoski. Stefan Robidov. 15 seconds of 4-on-4 remaining. Cody Ekins had that great chance early in this hockey game. Gets knocked down by Bystrick a couple of times, and then the call being made by Mike Hasenfratz. Cody Eakin is in the penalty box as he got tangled up with Bystrick, and here's what happened.
So Cody Eakin on this little forecheck here gets a little bump, and as he comes back here, puts his hand on that puck to push it back, I believe is what the call is for him. And then right before that, a good chance by Jamie Benn as it bounces over the stick of Schmid. But what a great last-ditch effort to dive, extend the stick, and denies the hottest Dallas Star from a high-quality chance.
So young or old, guys are still adjusting to that rule.
Yeah, for sure.
But put your hand on the puck. Oilers on the power play. 5-on-4 now as Emily fires it upstairs. Nugent Hopkins out of the penalty box. And it's checked by Nystrom. Hall comes to help out. Lays it down low. Hartikainen will give it to Hall. Hall takes a look from the corner. Being watched by Aaron Rome. Back to the point. Eberle, wrist shot. And that one missed high on the glove side. Nugent Hopkins back to the point. Justin Schultz waiting for it there. Nugent Hopkins takes a look. Here's Eberle firing it towards the net. Deflected. And Lettman leans back as the puck underneath him makes the save.
And another one of those plays that we were told to watch for a little bit from Ralph Krueger. Nice little move by Schultz to drive through to the middle. A center drive. Jordan Eberle comes up and is now the high guy. So he gets the shot through traffic. There's the first one that he puts up high and goes just over the net. Here's the play where Schultz drives through. Eberle becomes the shooter. And look at all the bodies in front of Lettman here with Hartikainen in front. All going looking for a rebound.
And he has a pretty good whack at this one here where Letton is able to cover it up.
Sam Gagner wins that faceoff. Billy tried to get it out. Corey Potter keeps it in. Now it's muscled out for Erickson. Louis Erickson stripped of the puck by Neil Yakupov. Sam Gagner starts away. 1:04 of power play time for the Oilers, their second. As Dillon fires that puck down the ice. Dallas, fifth best penalty killers on the road. The Oilers with the fifth best power play in the league. Kamsky plays it around the boards. And nobody home. Corey Potter has to race over and get it. He's got Garbutt all over. Quickly up for Gagner. Gagner to Yakupov. Yakupov checked by Ben. So Legowski chops it into the corner. Gagner waiting for it there with Magnus Bjarne. Bjarne trying to get it back to the point where Hall was, but instead it came to Ryan Garbutt. He fired it down the ice. Justin Schultz leads all rookies in power play goals with 4. Goligoski gets to it first, sends it around the board. Picked off. Hall's got it. Hall. Schultz moving to the middle. Petrie down low. Jeff Petrie flying. Fires a shot through traffic. Big save by Letton. The penalty is over. Less than a minute to go in the period. Oilers keep possession. Dustin Schultz with a backhand. Nugent Hopkins is the side of the net. Now it comes to the near side. Nugent Hopkins going after it. Keeps that puck alive for Eberle. Gets it back again. Nugent Hopkins. Backhand. And that one was behind Jordan Eberle.
Good effort by Nugent Hopkins to pounce on that loose puck. Had to out-battle a star in the corner to get it. Then a little spin around. A nice backhand pass. It just misses Eberle.
And offside is the call as Eager was ahead of the play.
When you look over the course of this season so far, Kevin, the top two lines of Edmonton have really been the offensive juggernaut, so to speak, and the other forward lines have not put up a whole lot of points in that regard. Starting to see a little bit of that secondary scoring and that scoring depth trickle through the lineup, but there's no question the top two lines of firing usually mean success for Edmonton.
And it usually means success on the power play, as well over 50% of the offense for the Oilers is coming with the man advantage.
15 seconds. 15.
Dillon takes a look. 14 seconds to go in this first period. They'll go right up the middle. Ben Eager almost picked that off. Intended for Ben. Ben sweeps it in. Dubnyk gives it to Potter. Around the boards for Petrell. Plays it off the boards high into the middle. And that will do it for the period. A period that sees the Oilers get the only goal. Hey, Brad Fay. The Oilers had 14 shots the last game. They've got 11 already through 20 minutes.
And Kevin, our focus will be at the other end as well. Devan Dubnyk outstanding again in that first period. And what does that mean now with Habib Bouling there being dangled perhaps as a possible chip? We'll discuss it with Doug McLean and Nick Kyprios. Highlights from around the NHL and more on a 1-0 lead for Edmonton. Through 20.
Well, Taylor Hall is celebrating the fact that he's got a goal, and Devan Dubnyk has himself a lead to work with this evening, similar to what was the case a few nights ago in Columbus. But the Oilers are looking a lot stronger and a lot more poised than maybe they did in periods 2 and 3. That's what they're hoping will be the case this evening as they take to the ice against the Dallas Stars, joined by Mark Spector. And the game of hockey can be simple, and did you get the sense that the Oilers played it that way in the first period?
Yeah, it's funny, we get this big team full of skill, all these first-round picks, and now we're saying, dump and chase, for Pete's sakes!
Get rid of it!
But I'll tell you what, this team's been far too fancy through the first 10 games of the season. We're watching it here. Ben Eager tosses it in, gets to a puck. You can see a concerted effort by all the lines. This is Taylor Hall doing the same thing. Ralph Kruger's been pushing over for a few games, and these guys have taken a while to pick it up. I got to say, a little bit of stubbornness is starting to come through. There's Petrell. What is the common thread of all those three dump ins? Gino, the Oiler got to the puck first every time. On that one, no need to dump it in because he didn't have to take guys on one-on-one. Taylor all hangs on, shot goes in. If you keep shooting, you give the goalie a chance to maybe blow one a little bit. That's what he did there.
So that's why number four has three on the season. Now, what about number 19? What do you think of Justin Schultz?
Now, I was talking to Darryl Ray this morning. Everybody knows Darryl, former Oiler goalie, a Dallas Stars analyst. He said, this guy reminds me of Sergei Zubov. I'll tell you what, Oiler fan doesn't need to hear. That's one of the highest forms of praises. Sergei Zubov killed us here in Edmonton for how many years, Gino? Watch him here running the power play like a veteran. He does all the things. Keeps the puck in there. Look at that spin move. I mean, that's tons of skill and even more confident. And watch him come down in the zone here. Opens up things for Everly. He knows he's got to create some space. There you go. Get a shot for the point. This kid is not only fourth. He is still second in AHL scoring. Overall, he's the fourth leading rookie scorer in the National Hockey League. Decent shot at Calder there. Good-looking player. Holy cow, 19, huh?
And no surprise he's on the ice. He leads the Oilers in that when it comes to 23 minutes and 2 seconds per game is spent on the ice, guys.
Absolutely, Gene. He spent 7 minutes and 29 seconds of the first period on the ice. Oh, these all rookies. Another huge hit this time by the other Schultz, Nick Schultz and Justin Schultz combining, and then a shot by Hall. Lettinen makes the save and he'll hang on to it. But that physical thing that Ralph Krueger was pushing and you were talking about in our keys continues.
Right there, a big boom on Jaromír Jágr. Not an easy guy to knock over. Had his head down, Justin Schultz. Nick Schultz comes over and just gives him a good pop with the shoulder. It leads to a turnover on the transition. It's Taylor Hall with another good shot. Jamie Benn comes over and has a few words for Nick Schultz. But I like the tenacity right now by the Edmonton Oilers. And as Mark Spector talked about, when you start dumping pucks in, you start chasing it, look how much room you have when you come over the blue line now. They're a little bit gun-shy to stand up because they're going to get beat.
Nugent Hopkins plays it back to the point. Nick Schultz will give it to Justin Schultz. To Taylor Hall. Hall fires it towards the cage. Lettinen steers that aside. Nugent Hopkins picks it up. Drops it back for Everly. Everly spins to get away from Ben. Jordan Everly. Nugent Hopkins behind the net. Watched by Larson. Nugent Hopkins still has it. Nugent Hopkins to Justin Schultz. Schultz back to Hall. Hall with a wrist shot through traffic. And a glove save by Kari Lettinen. He juggled it and hung on to it. Let's take a look at the first period scoring summary brought to you by Warley Parsons Court. Now hiring trades in oil country. Visit warleyparsonscourt.com/careers and apply today.
Well, that guy you just saw on the screen there, Taylor Hall, with his fourth goal over the years, assisted by Jordan Eberle. And a good period overall for Edmonton. 11 shots to 5 in favor of them over Dallas. And again, coming out with a shooting mentality, traffic in front. Good save by there by Lettinen as that puck did dribble out for just a second. But he gets the glove out and snatches it up.
Taylor Hall's got 6 of the 11 shots the Oilers have taken so far in this hockey game. He's got all 3 shots this period. Vladislav Schmid. Behind the net, great start for the Oilers as they have dominated territorially in this first minute. With their second line out there now. Gagne waiting for it. Schmid pinches. Michael Weiner puts him to the boards. Yakubov behind the net. Avoids the hit from Robidas. The puck comes to the near side. Dillard going after it. He takes a hit from Yakubov. Robidas looks by. There's Schmid to keep it in.
Solid pinches by Ladislav Schmid. Just jumping down, anticipating, keeping pucks alive in the offensive zone.
Dillard behind the net. Stripped of the puck by Yakubov. And now it's picked up by Erickson. And he will skate it out. Louis Erickson will backhand that puck in. Potter against Ryder. Corey Potter, give it a bump, gets knocked down by Michael Ryder. Ryder comes up with the puck, he's got Derek Roy in front, and a great save by Devin Dubnyk.
Right, that was a slick little shot there by Roy, too, as he tried to go across the grain on Dubnyk. He gets a pat down.
Tomorrow, the Rotary Club of Edmonton is putting Oilers president and COO Patrick LaForge on the defense, taking shots from 8 high-profile Edmontonians at the ATB Financial Rotary Roast of Patrick LaForge. All proceeds will be directed to the Boys and Girls Club and Big Brothers and Big Sisters Macaulay Club. Tickets are $100 and visit EdmontonOilers.com for more information and to secure your seat. It'll be a roast, so you know it'll be well done.
Mark Fiskrick and Jeff Petrie on the ice right now. Mark Fiskrick, 4 hits in that first period against his old team, the first time he has played them after half a dozen years playing in Texas. Petrie, wrist shot through traffic, Hartikainen backhand, and that one didn't miss by a lot. District at the point. Keeps it in. Hartikainen, PRB, and Belanger keeping the pressure on this Dallas Stars team in this first period. Trevor Daly. PRB runs into him. A bouncing puck comes down for Petrie. Jeff Petrie. Thomas Spensour steals that away, played it back, and it went right on to Lettman. And Lettman's going to take matters into his own hands and send it down the ice. No icing. Petrie cuts it around the near side. Pushed ahead for Piarvi. Piarvi moving in against Goligoski. Here's Piarvi behind the net. Vandevelde's out in front. Chris Vandevelde from the corner. Cycles down low for Ben Eager. Ben Eager muscles his way to that puck. Takes a hit, stays on it. Vandevelde in support. Ryan Garbutt will try his best to get it out and does. Rolls it slowly down the ice. Nick Schultz will touch it, and that's going to be icing. But the Oilers come out firing in this second period.
In this game period, what a totally different look to this team. Here's that chance by Hartikainen here as he doesn't really know where the puck is. He just kind of finds it in his feet, just rips the backhand a little bit wide. But a good chance again with that presence in front. And as I mentioned, a totally night and day different team here from the game against Columbus a couple nights ago. All over the forecheck, banging bodies, turning over loose pucks, creating shots on the net.
And look at the shot total already. 14 shots. They had 14 shots the entire game against Columbus. Ryan Garbutt sends it in. Dubnyk stays calm. Gets that puck out to Ben Eager. Ben Eager dumps it in. Lettinen slows it down. Petrell going after it. Justin Schultz trying to pinch in and keep it in against Vern Fiddler. Justin Schultz around the far side it goes. Eager with a big hit on Robida. Stars get it out. Race for it. Fiddler will get there first. Vern Fiddler from the corner. Garbutt fires a wrist shot. That didn't make it through. That was blocked up by Schultz. Robida fires a long shot in as the Dallas Stars make changes. Nystrom leads it in the corner for Ryder. Michael Ryder comes out of the corner, plays it back to Dillon at the point, over to Robida, wrist shot. That one gets deflected wide. Nick Schultz against Derek Roy. Back to the point he comes. Robida to Dillon. Brendan Dillon with a wrist shot. That went off Leonard Petrell and somehow bounces into the net. Put that in the category of strange. We're tied at one.
Good forecheck by Dallas here, getting to the offensive zone. And again, you get the puck into the danger zone, good things happen for Robida. He just kind of ripped it down low. And this one did take a funny hop. But a good D-to-D pass here. Sorry, it wasn't Robida. It was Dillon. And he's going to get credit for the goal. So a second career goal here as this one goes off the back wall, off the back of Devin Dubnyk, who can't find it off the glass, and it trickles into the net.
His second career goal. Or the youngster, Brendan Dillon.
I can pretty much say he's never going to score one like that again in his career. That was a pretty funky pass, but he'll take it and ties the game.
4:23 in, the Oilers all over the Dallas Stars in that first period, but Brendan Dillon gets the goal. And it's a 1-1 game. Came in without a point his last four games. Got the Gordie Howe hat trick February 1st against Phoenix.
Time, 4 minutes.
Stefan Robida gets the helper. Nugent Hopkins, Hole with a shot. Stop. Hole's going to get top angle shot. Lettinen's way out of the net. Now he finds the puck and he'll hang on to it. Great effort by Nugent Hopkins and Hall, and they had Kari Lettinen all over the place.
Takes a couple shots from Brendan Moore. They had a couple run-ins last year in Nugent Hopkins' rookie year as well, and they still have a conversation as it goes out of the zone. Good forecheck once again. Hall and Nugent Hopkins just aggressively pursued that puck. Good keeped in by Schultz to keep this whole thing alive, and look at the scramble in front as Jordan Everly just couldn't seem to get a handle on this puck. In his skates, and a good job by Lettinen to get back across and cover it up. His danger was looming.
Lettinen is 8-2 in his career against the Edmonton Oilers. From the faceoff, won by Derek Roy. Larson sends it around the boards. Fisker keeps it in, throws it towards the net. Blocker save by Lettinen. Hampson, Gagne, and Yakupov. Yakupov in the corner against Philip Larson. Ryder's trying to get it out, can't do it, and now he will. Derek Roy to Michael Ryder. Ryder moving in with Erickson. Good defensive play by Petrie. He blocked that pass coming over to Erickson. Ryder out in front. Erickson fires that shot high over the net. Gagne chops at it to Yakupov. Yakupov stopped up by Roy. Here's Ryder. One-timer. He didn't get all of that. He was off balance and let that shot go. Gagne to Yakupov. Yakupov stopped up against Larson. Plays it to the middle. To Legoski, to Garbin. He gets stopped by Nick Schultz.
Good.
Kempski trying to get that puck out. It does. Wow, look at that. Everybody digging for it.
You call digging for a puck. Two both teams is battling. I'll tell you, the urgency and the aggression's gone up for Dallas here in the second period. A much better team. They're starting to get aggressive themselves, and we're having some end-to-end action here.
Replays and live shots from our net cams are brought to you by LASIK MD, providing you with a 2020 view of all the action, and we have seen a lot of action in this second period.
A lot of action around the net as well, and you know what? You have to play good defense to win hockey games, and Jeff Petrie's one of those guys with a great stick. As you watch him here, he just kind of comes across, knows it's a two-on-one, knows he has a presence in Hemsky coming back. He closes quickly and steals the puck, so a real good defensive play there. That could have been a two-on-one.
Jeff Petrie leads this team in takeaways. Came into the game with 10. Still looking for his first point of the season. Justin Schultz gives it back to Nick. Nick to the opposite corner. Hall going after it against Robida. Taylor Hall surrounded. Ryder there as well. Everly. Hall come together. Nugent Hopkins ends up with a puck. Here's Hall. Wrist shot. Letting the save as he was at the top of the blue paint. Opportunity now. Nugent Hopkins to Everly. Everly behind the net. Everly trying to feed that puck out in front. Hall near side. He'll play it back to Justin Schultz. Over to Nick Schultz. Nick Schultz will give it to Nugent Hopkins to Everly. Everly walks in. A wrist shot goes off Trevor Daly. And up out of play. Well, Brendan Dillon gets his second goal in the National Hockey League. Strangest one he'll ever score.
During the lockout, Jamie Benn was playing in Germany, and during an international break, he went on a short trip to Italy, specifically to Rome, and one of his first stops was a trip to the Vatican, but his favorite, most amazing place to see was the Colosseum. He spent a total of 4 days in the Italian city. It was his first ever trip to Rome, and finally he can say, been there, done there.
Gladiator style.
12th game against the Oilers. He's got 14 points against Edmonton. This Dallas Stars team has owned the Oilers since they moved from Minnesota. 54-12-7, their record. Same number of wins for Dallas as was Minnesota. 758. 19 years in Dallas, 26 years in Minnesota. Right now it's a 1-1 game as Aaron Rome's weak shot handled by Devin Dubnyk.
Going back to Jamie Benn and Sam Gagne, both drafted back in 2007. Benn was drafted 129th by Dallas and Gagne 6th overall by Edmonton. When you look at the numbers that they put up this season and in the history of time, all drafted players from 2007, Gagne sits 2nd in goals with 81. Benn is 4th with 74. So a couple of real good high-quality guys come out of that draft, and Patrick Kane is leading that number with 135. So some high-end talent.
Jamie Benn here tonight. Second star in the NHL of the week. Patrick Kane was the first star. Another big hit as Robida feels the wrath of Ben Eager. Eager and Fisrick both on the ice right now. Eager with Belanger and Petrel. Thomas Vinsour drops it back. Eager. Vinsour. Checked by Fisker. Riley Smith behind the net. Riley Smith trying to work his way out. Given two shots and a penalty coming up to the Edmonton Oilers. Larson waits, fires it through traffic. The net empty as Fisker touches the puck. And it's going to be a holding call against Ben Eager.
Here is the basket of half-eaten zucchini sticks from the win known as Money Monday.
Get your game on with Pools.
Safeway's featured participating product for tonight's hockey game is Tostitos Tortilla Chips.
And as you mentioned, Kevin, Benny here is going to go to the box right there for that arm wraparound on the Dallas player. Riley Smith it was that he grabbed a hold of. Just tried to go in for the hit. That little move reaches his arm out. Goes to the box for two. So that physical play is good, but you got to know the limit. Just got a little bit aggressive on that one. That nails the second power play for the Dallas Stars. They got three shots. They had the power play in the first period. Fired in by Goligoski. Moro, Ben, and Jagr up front. Jamie Benn with a puck now. Benn all the way back to Goligoski. He'll give it over to Larson. Larson being watched by Petrell. Is up front with Belanger. Schmid and Nick Schultz are the blue liners to start this penalty kill. Jagr parks himself behind the net. He'll give it to Jamie Benn. Benn. Back to the point. Goligoski being watched by Belanger. Delivers to Benn. Benn with a wrist shot through traffic. Club save. And the rebound cleared out as Goligoski couldn't keep it in. Jaromir Jagr. Moro goes cross ice, but that pass did not work to Larson. It's offside. Power play, as we mentioned, for Dallas that has struggled on the road. It's ranked 24th in the league.
Yeah, when you look at the average goals per game, it's just 2.08 for Glenn Gullickson. Wants to see that number elevated, and obviously getting shots to that one of the lower shooting teams in the National Hockey League, along with Edmonton, not getting enough pucks to that, not enough bodies there. They've been better tonight, and have clawed back into this one to tie it 1-1.
But the power play struggles that they've had this year, only 7 power play goals, obviously lead to that number as well. But they've been better in the last couple.
We got 45 seconds to go, and the penalty to Ben Jagr is Trevor Daly. Crosses the blue line, chips it in, goes right after it. He's got Smith on the near side. Riley Smith trying to get it back to him. Daly still has it to Ryder. Ryder to Derek Roy. Roy fakes the shot, turned away as Vandevelde was watching him. And then good hand-eye coordination, knocking it down with Gagne. Sam Gagne moving in shorthanded. He's got Vandevelde with him. Chris Vandevelde in the corner against Louis Erickson. Won't let him escape. And now it comes out. Erickson's got it. He's with Riley Smith. 10 seconds to go in the power play. And that's the value for Chris Vandevelde. Center called up. His ability to kill penalties.
Now big body, that long reach. He's strong on the puck. And that was a real smart play there by Gagne. He knew, he took a look up. He saw that Derek Roy, a forward, was playing defense. And that's the side that he attacked.
Belanger feeds it through for Eaters out of the penalty box. One shot for the Dallas Stars on that power play. Both teams now 0-2. 18-13, the shots favor the Oilers. Taylor Hall has been doing most of the shooting.
Oh, a nice double strike.
Harnikainen joins him behind the net. Trying to dig that puck free. Harnikainen given a bump there by Dillon. Down the boards, Justin Schultz keeps it in against Vern Fiddler. Now Fiddler works it out to an open wing. It is picked up by Nystrom. He's got Garbutt with him. They crisscross at the blue line. Ryan Garbutt fires a shot towards the net. That one misses. Comes all the way to the near side. Kept in by Larson.
Puck.
Piardi bounces it off the boards. Wants to get a change in. Jordan Eberle hops over the boards. Eric Nystrom chased back into his own zone. Plays it off the glass. Gets it out to center. Garbutt there. He'll just shoot that puck in and head off. 8:35 to go in the second period in a 1-1 game. Right up the middle off the stick of Taylor Hall. Larson gets to it first. Pass picked up by Nugent Hopkins. Riley Smith starts away with Thomas Ventura. He'll give it to Cody Eakin. Quickly dishes it to Goligoski. Goligoski trying to get it back to him. Went off the stick of Petrie and ends up as a souvenir. Tell us, Oilers hockey here on Sportsnet.
The UEFA Champions League soccer features the match that the world wants to see tomorrow afternoon at 12:30 p.m. Mountain. Manchester United travels to Real Madrid in Leg 1 in the round of 16 on Sportsnet West, Pacific East, and Ontario. Look at a couple of Oilers that would prefer to be in the lineup. One because of injury, that being Sean Horkoff. The other because Well, being a healthy scratch, Ryan Smith, who preferred today Louis and Kevin not to talk, he'll mull it over before he responds to what happened to him, courtesy of head coach Ralph Krupp.
From the faceoff, Erickson, from a sharp angle, stopped by Dubnyk. Wider from one knee. Lost control of the puck. Alex Hempsey starts away. He'll give it to Belanger. Belanger. And offside is the call.
You know, for Ralph Kruger this morning, Kevin, you know, had a lengthy conversation about the fact that Ryan Smith was a healthy scratch tonight and Ryan Whitney. And, you know, he answered about seven straight questions on the topic and said, okay, listen, there's 20 guys that are pretty eager to be in the lineup tonight. But listen, big news when a guy over 1,000 games is scratched, Ryan Smith, and Ryan Whitney, one of your veteran defensemen. But for him, it's about accountability. And right now, the fact that he's going to put what he feels is the best team forward to play a game, to win a game. And everybody has to be bought in and involved in that. He thinks that this can help both Whitney and Smith be better hockey players in the future.
And Gagne centering pass! Petrie denied. Lettinen slides across and makes his biggest save of the hockey game. Oilers still coming. Here's Hemsky's shot blocked. Gagne's shot's blocked. Yakupov's shot missed the target. Shooting gallery of the Dallas end. Hemsky behind the net. Michael Ryder has it now, wants to relieve the pressure and does as Jeff Petrie comes oh so close to his first point of the season. District takes a look, 7-10 to go in the period. 19 shots for the Oilers. Not sure why that wasn't an ice on Dallas. Tanner Hall fans on the shot. Jagr was all over him. Ben back the other way with Moore. Jamie Benn cuts to the middle. Shot steered aside by Dubnyk. Benn gets to it again. Around it. Coming away with a puck is Nugent Hopkins quickly to Hall. Hall with speed. Moving in. Here's Hall. Having that shot, but it goes wide and he tried to get the pass to the middle. Chopped back in. Brendan Morrow will pick it up. Nugent Hopkins watching him. Robidoff quickly back to Brendan Dillon. Dillon will give it to the veteran Robidoff. Jamie Benn to the middle for Dillon. Dillon moving in. Dillon this time on net. Big rebound. Side of the net for Morrow. Glove save by Dubnyk. Round the world we go. Dubnyk makes the save.
Great anticipation there. Dubnyk read that play all the way. A couple real good opportunities for Edmonton. The first one here walked in from the angle. It's Petrie with the one-timer that has a great chance here. This one here eventually will work its way right to Yakupov wide open, and he just goes for a little too much and can't put it up over top of Lettinen. And here's that save by Dubnyk. Look at him already over there, ready for that pass. Read it the whole way. Made an easy glove hand save.
17 shots fired his way by the Dallas Stars. 40 shots he faced against Columbus. No one has made more saves in the National Hockey League this year than Devan Dubnyk.
And that's a good thing and a real bad thing. Yeah. Obviously, it's a great thing because your goaltender's playing great. It's a bad thing because you're giving up way too many shots per game, something Edmonton would like to remedy.
Nine times they have been outshot by the opponent. Petrell centering pass for Vandevelde. Trying to muscle that one in, and that's what you expect from this line. Eager, Vandevelde and Petrell putting the hard hats on.
Great back check there by Petrell. He almost kept that puck in the zone. Just relentless on the puck right now.
All the way, and Daly can't keep it in on the far side. Tell us Oilers hockey from Rexall Place right here on SNET.
Well, two teams with a little different tales here this year. As you look at the fourth oldest team in the National Hockey League, Dallas at 29.37 years average, and Edmonton, the youngest in the National Hockey League, with eight players under 23 years old, being the youngest in the league. And going toe-to-toe in this one here, it doesn't help when you have two 40-year-olds on your team. Ray Whitney out right now, the Fort Saskatchewan native, with a on the injury reserve with a knee injury, and Jaromir Jagr is going to turn 41 very shortly.
Now, speaking of age, Dan Parrish turned blue today. Happy birthday to Dan, our director. How did they bleep that? I gave the age. Right on from a sharp angle. Lettinen the save. Eichstrom strikes back. 5 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the second period in a 1-1 game. Tiarvi. Nice little pass for Hartikainen. Petrie. And at that great chance earlier, sweeps the puck in. Trevor Daly will pick it up. Daly to the middle for Fiddler. He'll give it to Nystrom with Garbutt. Nystrom trying to get around. Petrie delivers the hit. knocks him down. The puck comes back to the point to Dillon. Petrie gets his stick chopped out of his hand. Play continues.
A couple of college rivals right there. Nystrom with the University of Michigan and Petrie, Michigan State. Still don't like each other.
Erickson shot up high. And Dubnyk makes the save.
Pro Hockey Life, the ultimate hockey megastore.
A new issue of Sportsnet magazine is out on newsstands right now. Find out if Ryan Nugent-Hopkins is the one to bring the Oilers to the promised land.
Oilers with 8 shots in the second period, 6 quality scoring chances, according to our crack statistician, Paul E. Dangerously.
He's never wrong.
Never wrong. Schultz sends it around the boards. Yakupov gave it away. Derek Roy throws it towards the net. That one missed. Picked up on the near side and chucked out by Gagne to center. 22-18, the shots favor the Oilers, who outshot the Dallas Stars 11-9 in that first period. Stefan Robidoff, 35 years old in his 12th year in the National Hockey League, playing with a guy who played one game last year, Brendan Dillon. Dillon's got the only goal for the Dallas Stars, and it was a fluky one. Ryder. Something short's got a stick in the way of that shot. Erickson picks it up on the far side. Back to the point it comes. Once again, the Dallas Stars unable to keep that puck in at the blue line.
We've seen that a couple times, 3 times already in this game, where that pass D to D has just been a little bit off. And the reason being the pressure by Evans and getting on the defense quickly, taking that time and space away. When you rush that pass, not as easy to make it straight across.
Jaromir Jagr with it now. Over with Morrow and Ben. Jagr stops up. Jagr. He and Schultz go down. The puck is still free. Everly against Ben now. Hall's got it. Takes a hit from Ben. Stays in. Morrow to Jagr. Jaromir Jagr drives towards the net. Puck loose. Picked up by Hall. Boy, the big man goes to the net. 240-pound freight train.
Do not watch the puck with Jaromir Jagr. I made the mistake of that a couple times in one game. Took 2 penalties on the big man, hauling him down. If he was going to do what he just did, walk right into the net. And he's so good around that area. From the hash marks down, I don't know if you can name a better guy in the last 20 years that could take a puck to the net with the skill inside the size that Jagr has. And a good save there as he comes out and doesn't get quite all of it.
Number 6,
Taylor Hall clears out of harm's way.
68's got 668 goals.
As the 10th all time.
Rome behind the net for Vintur. Stolen by Potter. Now he gets it back again. Out of Vintur. Starred here for the Oil Kings. Eakin, the backhand. Blocked by Schmid. Cody Eakin gets it again. Vintur. Riley Smith out in front. Potter knocks down Vintur. Riley Smith being worked over there by Schmid. Puck finally does come free, and it's sent down the ice. Petrell in a foot race with Aaron Rome. No icing, good hustle by Petrell. And then once again, Rome may have put his hand on the puck. The second time that has happened in this game, there's a conference.
And he is going to get a penalty for it. You know, a good job by Petrell to kind of signal, hey, you know what, he put his hand over that puck, but I think that it wasn't recognized right away. And you'll see as he falls down, he knows he's been beat right there, and the linesman clearly sees it. And they had a little discussion in the corner, and I think it was called via conference.
Mark Wheeler saw that and informed Mike Hasenfratz, and he made the call. What's the call?
Yeah, you know, it's amazing. You know, this has been a rule they've been calling a lot this year, and guys just can't seem to figure it out. Just like after they came back from the lockout in 2005-06, the hooking penalties went way up. Anything in the midsection was going to be called. That took everybody about 20 games, 25 games. Hey, we're still calling it now, but it's that old habit to dig a stick in, and it's that old habit to put a hand on a puck to get it out of harm's way.
And it already happened in this game.
Yep, it happened right there. And the fact that Rome got up and said, what did I do? It's just, you just totally go blank sometimes. You don't think about it. It's an honest mistake. It's going to take some time for that to sink in. You just can't do that anymore.
3 power plays for the Oilers. 2 of them on that call. The Oilers generated 4 shots. Their 2 previous man advantages. Justin Schultz leads the charge. Pass to Hartikainen. Hartikainen sweeps it in. Lettman stops it behind the net. Plays it around the boards. Can't get it by Jordan Eberle. Now back to the point. Good job by Justin Schultz to keep that puck in. Knocked down by Dillon. He chops at it. It comes free. Nugent Hopkins picks it up. Ryan Nugent Hopkins back to Justin Schultz. He'll go cross ice. Jordan Eberle takes a look. Hartikainen's in front. Drops it back to Justin Schultz. Rich shot through traffic. And a glove save by Lettman.
Dallas Flames hockey is back on Friday night when Calgary hosts the St. Louis Blues at 6:30 p.m. Mountain. That's on Sportsnet West. Then on Thursday, the 21st of this month, Dallas Oilers hockey is back here at Rexall as the Minnesota Wild visit Edmonton at 7 p.m. Mountain, of course, on Sportsnet West.
1:06 to go in the penalty, 1:32 to go in the period. Sam Gagne against Cody Eakin. Eakin wins that draw, but the Oilers get possession, and Paul takes it away from Philip Larson. He'll play it back to the point. Hemsky waiting for it. Here comes a one-timer from Potter. Oh, what a save as Gagne was robbed. Sam Gagne hangs onto it. Gagne. Paul snapped his stick on that shot attempt, and he'll have to go to the bench to get a new one. Potter being hounded now by Fiddler. 38 seconds of power play time remaining. Gagne fires it in. Hemsky waiting for him on the near side. Less than a minute to go in the period. Nystrom gets it to Daly. Daly under pressure from Hall. Plays it to the middle. Bert Fiddler starts away. He'll give it to Larson. Moving in shorthanded. Fiddler with the shot and he missed the target. 17 seconds to go. Gagne moves in. Gives it to Hall. Hall back to Petrie. Petrie delivers the puck to Hemsky. Hemsky, time winding down. Hemsky takes a slap shot. It dribbles through. Hall with a chance. Stopped by Lettman. Sent down the ice by Eric Nystrom. Penalty is over. Rome is back on the ice. 20 seconds to go in the period. The Oilers deliver five shots on that power play. Peaches right up the middle for Eberle. One last chance. Moving in. Eberle! Jordan Eberle comes close with time winding down in the period. Jordan Eberle without a goal in his last seven coming in, Brad. You don't get much closer than that. We're tied at 1-40.
Kevin Quinn, it's almost like he's been in our little production meeting here. It's exactly what we're going to talk about when we come back. The struggles of Eberle and Nugent Hopkins despite the good efforts of the young kids. Doug McLean, Nick Kyprios are here when we come back. It's the Oilers not getting the breaks on this night, and that's what you call a pretty good break for the Dallas Stars. That's why it's tied for 4.
Well, the Edmonton Oilers getting set for third period action as they hope to secure a win to start this five-game homestand here at Rexall Place. And I know in the pregame during the intermission, basically all day we've been talking about Ryan Smith and why he's in the lineup. And someone at home might say, well, why would you put Ben Eager in over Ryan Smith? And your response would be...
Well, because this team needs his size. They need the ability. We've talked about how they got to chip and chase a little bit. This is a guy who can chip and chase and make it hurt. Ben Eager could take that thing, chip it in. You'll see him here. Thank you. There's not many guys his size that can get in on the forecheck that quickly. And this is what, this is a good Ben Eager. You guys watching? Boom, that's Robidoff. Here comes the bad Ben Eager. Right here is a holding penalty. Boom, he's in the box. If Ben Eager, everyone in this organization wants Ben Eager to play and play more because they don't have much size and they don't have that aggression. If he stays out of the penalty box, he can pull it off. If he keeps in the box, probably going to see Ryan Smith back in here pretty quick.
All right, now a quarter and two periods into this season. Is Devan Dubnyk your team MVP?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's unbelievable how the Edmonton Oilers are struggling to score. A ton of chances tonight. 27 shots on goal through two. It's not going in. Why are they in every single game this season, except for San Jose? Because of this guy right here, number 40. He absolutely has fulfilled his job of giving his team a chance to win every single night. They're in it again tonight. They've only got one goal, but this one is up for grabs going into the third. Thanks to number 40, this Devan Dubnyk. If the question was, is he good enough to be the guy for this team? The answer right now is absolutely for sure.
One of the best in the league, and another number to digest. Only Jimmy Howard, Ilya Brizgalov, and Ryan Miller have played more minutes coming into tonight. Kevin and Louis will see how many more minutes Devan Dubnyk has to play this evening against Dallas.
All right, Gene, our scoring summary brought to you by Worley Parsons Cord. Now hiring trades in oil country. Visit worleyparsons.com/careers and apply today.
Taylor Hall in the first period makes a 1-0. Brendan Dillon with his second, a little bit of a fluky one past Dubnyk. That's how it stays locked up at one heading into this third.
Guys talking about 27 shots. Taylor Hall has 9 of them so far through 40 minutes.
That's really Ovechkin-like.
It is Ovechkin-like. Justin Schultz played 15 minutes, 24 seconds, but Taylor Hall has been the story, the only goal scorer, and 9 shots.
And I like the fact that he's firing the puck, and something that I think that Taylor Hall just getting the... the grasp of the National Hockey. He has a tremendous wrist shot. We saw him beat Lettinen, the only goal this game. And Lettinen's been up to the task, 26 saves so far, but 9 shots by Hall. You like seeing that. When he utilizes his speed, gets into places, and fires that puck, good things happen.
Vern Fiddler gets thrown out of the circle. Ryan Garbutt will step in against Ryan Nugent-Hopkins and wins it right back to Larson. He'll give it to Goligoski, fire at the corner. Nystrom steers it there, Garbutt. The Fiddler on the near side. Taylor Hall is there defensively. Fiddler gets away from him. Now he'll have to deal with Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. He'll play it back to the point. Goligoski keeps it in. Comes right to the side. Justin Schultz there. Nystrom took it away from him. Gave it to Fiddler. He throws it towards the net. That was blocked. Nystrom's got it again. Nystrom, his shot, scores through a screen. Ryan Dubnyk is not happy. Devan Dubnyk did not see that puck. And a quick strike for the Dallas Stars gives them their first lead of this hockey game.
And just a little floater through traffic on that. And I do believe this tips off of Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, who looks back at the last second, takes the man going to the net, and it goes off of his hand glove area past Devan Dubnyk. So Dubnyk looks like he's prepared for the shot, follows it coming as he goes down. That little bobble right before it gets to him. Follow the knuckle puck and just gets right off his face mask into the net. So that was going to be up high in the shoulder area. He's going to take that shot, goes off his helmet instead. So two fluky ones get by Devan Dubnyk. He shook off the first one, and he'll have to shake off the second one because Dallas comes out with a good first shift, and it leads to a goal.
Nystrom gets the goal just 44 seconds in. And Vern Fiddler gets the assist, and that is bad news for the Edmonton Oilers, because when Vern Fiddler gets an assist on any team that he has played against the Edmonton Oilers, his team is perfect. Coming in, he was a perfect 10-0. That includes stops in Nashville and Phoenix. The only guy that's happy about that right now in Edmonton is his dad, Bob. So Nystrom gets the goal. His first of the season, came in without a goal in his last 29 games. The Army with Belanger and Hartikainen. Dillon takes the Army down hard. And Magnus, the Army slow to get back. Bistrom lost it to Morrow. Petrie there defensively. The Stars making changes, and also Magnus Bjarvi an opportunity to get to the bench.
I don't know how that wasn't at all. It looked like Dillon got a little bit high up in the head area as he kind of reefed on Bjarvi.
Out in front, trying to jam it home is Chris Vandevelde. Eager with an opportunity. Eager back to the point. Here's Bistrick through traffic, and that one sails wide as Lettinen didn't have his stick. It was in front of him. He couldn't grab it. Robidoff. Ryder moving in with Derek Roy. Stopped at the line by Jeff Petrie. Bistrick given a bump there by Ryder. Michael Ryder turns. Roy pulling for the puck. Ryder throws it around the boards. Roy keeps it in. Justin Schultz will pick it up. Justin Schultz. Taylor Hall on the move. He's got Nick Schultz with him. Along with Nugent-Hopkins. Hall stops up. Checked by Goligoski. Flying in there, Jordan Eberle. Eberle takes the puck back to the point.
Nick Schultz shot deflected. And Lettman makes the pad save. Schultz takes a look. Nick Schultz. He'll go cross ice. Everly with Hall. Taylor Hall cutting for the front of the net against Aaron Rome. Ends up behind the cage. Nugent Hopkins with it now. Ryan Nugent Hopkins to Jordan Everly. Everly trying to get away from Riley Smith. Cycles down low for Hall. Taylor Hall trying to get the pass through. It was stopped. An opportunity now for Ventura. Ventura back to Daly. Trevor Daly with a shot. And that one may have grazed off the post. Jordan Everly lays it behind the net. Justin Schultz will pick it up there. Schultz will give it to Hall. Into the shift. Those guys dead tired. He'll flip it down the ice and get a change in. He won't be able to get out. It's icing.
This perfectly preserved uniform came to us via a generous donation from our champion's wife.
Get your game on with Pools.
Well, as you mentioned, Kevin, Piarvi went off there. You look at the little reach in here by Bjelland as he kind of gets the elbow up into the chest area and kind of reefs back on Piarvi in some agony on the bench. Obviously, a little bit twisted up on the play.
Bjelland, for a big man, gets away with one there. 6 foot three, 228 pounds. Got his second National Hockey League goal. But it's off Petrell, off the glass, off Devin Dubnyk and in. Nystrom has given the team the lead. Here is Jagr with an opportunity. Threw it in front. Corey Potter hammering Jamie Benn to the ice.
Good job by Potter to stay with Benn there, who was the one that initiated that whole play. Nice little move out of the defensive zone. And what a pass by Jagr.
Dylan. Another high check there on Yakupov.
That was by Dylan.
The Oilers trying to win their first game when tied after 40 minutes. Just the second time they've been involved in that game. Here is Fiddler with a shot. A glove save by Dubnyk, and he covers up the rebound. And now Fiddler doing a little pushing and shoving with the former Dallas Star. Mark Bystrick. Two Edmonton guys going at it. Bystrick, first game back, playing against his old team, and Vern Fiddler back in his hometown.
Brendan Morrow in that next two.
The Oilers and all other Canadian NHL clubs are proud to announce Hockey Talks, a month-long initiative to increase dialogue and awareness about mental health and effective treatments. This month, each Canadian team will raise awareness about the importance of education and open dialogue on mental health and wellness at a national level. On February 21st, the Edmonton Oilers Community Foundation and Oilers Ladies will host an in-game fundraiser where fans can purchase a limited edition hand-signed puck for $20 on the concourse. Fans who receive one of 25 gold-signed pucks will be the lucky recipient of a team-signed stick.
4:42, Lou, the time of the roughing calls against Fiddler and Bystrick. Dallas Stars, and first of five straight against the Northwest. They are 2-1 against this division. They have a 2-1 lead now in this third period. Larson, his shot goes wide. Four sees Hall. And Nugent Hopkins on the ice with Justin Schultz and Nick Schultz. Hall moving in. Here is Taylor Hall between his legs. And lost his footing. Couldn't catch up to the puck. Has an opportunity now against Louis Erickson. Pushes it back to the point. Justin Schultz over to Nick Schultz. Nick Schultz gives it to Hall. He was checked by Erickson. And it's cleared out of harm's way by Philip Larson. He'll change as Nick Schultz goes behind the net. Sam Gagner, Jordan Everly on the ice right now. Justin Schultz lost an edge. No harm, no foul. Topic. Up the middle it goes. Gagner to Everly. Everly flying in. Circles the net. Everly still has it. Throws it out in front. Trying to catch Justin Schultz. Schultz has got it now. He'll give it to Everly. Everly out of the corner against Aaron Rome to Sam Gagner. Down low. Petrie cross ice pass. Broken up there by Eakin. Picked up by Michael Ryder. 51 seconds to go in the penalties to Bystrick and Fiddler. Rome intercepted by Gagner and knocked down with a high stick of Aaron Rome.
couple good chances on this 4-4 action. Obviously, when you have a little more open ice, good defensive play by Hopkins. Finds Hull up the ice. He tries a little spin move, just loses a wheel and can't regain composure. And then another rush up the ice. Nice little pass here wide to Everly. He drives this thing right through. And a good job by him to get his head up, look back, and find players going to the net. And Petrie with a one-timer afterwards. So good attacking off the rush by Edmonton, 4-on-4.
Belanger 10-3 in the faceoff circle, 77% through 40 minutes. Out there to take the draw, and he wins another one. Back to Petrie at the point. Alashevsky. Hacked at by Ben. Gets by Jagr. Petrie at the point again. Petrie with a wrist shot through traffic, deflected just wide. Vladislav Schmini on the near side. 28 seconds of 4-on-4. Hemsky giving a bump. Belanger going after it. Knocked down! And squeezing it is Kari Lehtinen. So both Hemsky and Belanger paying the price to try and tie this hockey game. Still 2-1 here at Rexall. Tell us, Oilers hockey.
Mark Fistrick was in a special teams meeting with the Dallas Stars when someone came into the meeting, that being one of the Stars' trainers, Steve Sumner, and said, hey, Mark, Joe Nieuwendyk wants to see you. The Dallas GM at that point in time when he met with Fistrick told him that he had been traded, but it was a couple of minutes actually before Fistrick was actually told that he was traded to Edmonton, which gave the former Star a new start.
He's in the penalty box right now, Gene, for the next 18 seconds, 4-on-4. Shots 30-22 in favor of the Oilers, but they trail by one. Goligoski. Stopped by Belanger. Out of the near side, Goligoski's got it again. Teams at even strength. District and Schindler out of the box. 13:09 to go in regulation time. Nick Schultz just going to dump it in. He'll head off. Everly, Hall, Nugent, Hopkins hop over the boards with Petrie and Schmid. Jarvin dumps it in the opposite corner. Racing after it. Fiddler. Jarvin gets there first again ahead of Schmid. Now the side of that Fiddler's shot goes just wide. Everly picks it up. Takes a bump from Fiddler. Hall gets by Rome. Tanner Hall. High up by Nystrom, takes him hard into the boards. Nugent Hopkins to Everly. Jordan Everly. To Nugent Hopkins, being watched by Trevor Daley. Nugent Hopkins spinning. Now with a backhand right on. Great chance for Everly as well. Stopped by Lehtinen. Petrie with a long shot. Glove save by Kari Lehtinen.
Cheers for the home team from the home team. Home Hardware. Homeowners helping homeowners. With expert advice.
Just a terrific little button hook here by Ryan Nugent Hopkins. He's been all over the puck tonight. Everly gets a little whack at it, and then Petrie with a nice shot through traffic. This top line of Edmonton has been all over it tonight. Taylor Hall has the only goal for them, and they've been creating chances not only off the rush, but that creativity down low on the cycle. Just giving the Dallas Stars fits in the defensive zone.
Tonight's Safeway $1 million Score and Win grand prize winner will receive an all-inclusive trip for two to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, courtesy of redtag.ca. Tonight's grand prize winner is Gary Clapperton of Leduc. Congratulations, Gary. Shop and swipe your club card at Safeway today, and you could be our next lucky winner.
Chris Vandevelde wins that draw. Dustin Schultz looking for Eager. Too far for him. The Army up there with Vandevelde as well. Vandevelde with the hit, the steal by Bjarvi. This line able to keep the puck in the Dallas end. Morrill works it out to center. Eager trying to track him down. Dillon will give it to Robidoff. Robidoff to Ben. Spun around there by Bjarvi. Eager flying around. Jaromir Jagr against Magnus Bjarvi. Jagr still has it. Jagr from the corner. Back up top it goes. Goligoski with a shot that misses. Jagr looking for the rebound. Ben picks it up. Ben behind the net. Morrill with it now. Morrill to Ben. Back to Goligoski. He'll give it to Ben. Centering pass from Morrill from Jagr. That didn't work. Goligoski keeps it in. Larson steps into a slap shot. That was blocked by Bjarvi. Eager, the RBN, Vandeveld, dead tired. Here's Larson's shot, then Devin Dubnyk makes the save. He'll get the whistle, and the Oilers will get a change.
A little bit of a mismatch there on the ice for the Oilers. There's the top line of Dallas. Good cycle down low, and a tired fourth line for Edmonton as they get out there and get caught in the defensive zone. Good save by Dubnyk to kind of finish things off, hold on, and get a whistle and a fresh set of legs on the ice. But when you have Yager, Morrow, Ben cycling the puck down low, really hard to contend for anybody. And good traffic in front there, good block to limit a real high-quality chance.
Smith from the point! Devin Dubnyk got a piece of that and it dribbled wide. Hemsky gets it out to center. It's picked up there by Belanger. Belanger moving in. Belanger against Rome. Back to the point. Corey Potter lets the shot go. Gagne looking for the rebound. Potter pitches to try and keep it in and does against Eakin. His stick shatters. Gagne tied up there by Daly. Hemsky in against Vinsour. Gagne gets knocked down. Daly to an open wing. Couldn't get it to Eakin. Eakin didn't have a stick. Oilers make a change. They'll send that top line out there.
We're going to see a lot of this top line here in the last 10 minutes of this game. Down by one, 3 days off. A rare break for Edmonton here in this shortened season.
Jordan Eberle shot from a sharp angle. Ball to Eberle. To Hall around the boards. Nugent Hopkins against Robidoux. To Hall. Hall tripped up. Roy, the Ryder, and that allows it to come to Erickson. He'll get it to Derek Roy. Derek Roy steps into a shot. That puck was rolling. Ryder keeps it in. Ryder, Roy, centering. There is Schmid to prevent anything from happening.
Guys are going down.
Schmid with an opportunity to get it out now. He'll give it to Jeff Petrie. Petrie. Around the boards for Schmid on the far side. Under 10 minutes left to go in regulation time as Taylor Hall brings it in, and then he'll head off. PRB with Belanger and Hartikainen. Justin Schultz for PRB. Magnus PRB behind the net. PRB back to the point. Nick Schultz with a shot. That one rises over top of the cage. Hartikainen races over to get to it. Larson plays it off the glass. Can't get it out though. Keeping it in is Belanger at the line. Magnus PRV in the corner. Garvin quickly to Fidler. He's got Nystrom with him. Nystrom with a go-ahead goal. 44 seconds into this period. These two teams will meet again in Dallas February the 28th. Sam Gagne trying to skate away from Nystrom. Fires it to an open wing. Picked off there by Daly. Trevor Daly brings it in. Daly circles the net against Nick Schultz. Daly to Ryan Garvin. Garvin checked by Justin Schultz. Coming away with it now is Gagne. Quickly up for Yakupov. Yakupov off the end of his stick. Rome was there to an open wing. Corey Potter is going to go back and touch that puck, and it's going to be icing against Dallas.
A software genius and an ex-CIA operative work together to prevent violent crimes before they can happen. Person of Interest is on Thursday night at 10 p.m. Mountain on City TV.
The Oilers outshot Dallas the last time these teams met, 29-28. They are outshooting them right now, 34-25, but they trail by one. Gagne, Yakupov, and Hemsky, Schmid, and Potter. Gagne will step in against Ryan Garbutt. He gets tossed out of the circle, and Jamie Benn will step in. From the draw, one by Gagne. Yakupov, along the wing, has his pocket picked by Benn. Garbutt's got it. Takes a shot from Schmid as he delivers the puck in. Benn, giving a bump. Yager trying to keep it in against Hemsky. Does for Ben. Ben against Potter. Potter lost it to Morrow. Yager with a shot. Stopped by Devin Dubnyk, who is hugging the post. Jaromir Yager still has it. Gives it to Ben in the middle. Gets it right back again. Now he'll fire it towards the back of the net. Morrow knocked down by Potter. Hemsky for Gagne. Off his skate. Ben at the end of the shift will just dump that puck in. Take a look at the clock. 7 minutes, 20 seconds to go in regulation time. Eberle, Nugent, Hopkins, and Hall are back on the ice. Nugent Hopkins skates away from Vinshore. Eberle plays it back to Petrie. Petrie to Pfister. Mark Pfister. Nugent Hopkins turns in his own zone. Quick pass for Hall. Hall trying to push it ahead to Eberle. It was broken up by Goligoski. Pfister waits and then dumps that puck in. Alex Goligoski sets up shot behind his own net. 34-26, the shots favor the Oilers. Smith to Eakin. Eakin moving in. Snaps the shot. What a save by Dubnyk. Rebound is loose for Vinsur. Steered to the corner. Riley Smith trying to center it. Cody Eakin has been stopped twice, point blank, by Devin Dubnyk. Right back the other way. A chance for Petrie. Petrie hangs onto it. A penalty on the way. The Oilers with a power play coming up. 6:25 to go here in regulation time on Sportsnet. Outstanding play, outstanding results. Brought to you by RE/MAX, Canada's most productive agents.
Back in the first period, the only goal so far to get by Kari Lehtinen. It was a real quick little release here. Handcuffer by Taylor Hall as he just gets his head up, takes a look, finds a hole, and puts it through him for an early 1-0 lead. Dallas has climbed back, scored two unanswered goals, lead it 2-1 with 6:25, and a power play coming up to Edmonton.
Cody Egan in the penalty box for holding. And the Oilers with their fourth power play of the game. They were 1-for-4 the last time these teams met. An opportunity to tie the game right now. Eberle with the puck. Eberle right down. Oh, for Gagner! Oh, what a save by Kari Lehtinen.
Unreal.
Ryan Nugent Hopkins bid for his first goal of the season.
Absolutely incredible. A long look from Ryan Nugent Hopkins afterwards. He's a little bit in disbelief that this one doesn't go by. But Kari Lehtinen's had one of those games tonight where he's made some terrific saves. Edmonton's gotten pucks to him early and often. And right here, a good look at it as Ryan Nugent Hopkins just tries to force this one right through. Looks like he's down and out. And the sprawling Lehtinen makes the save. Terrific save just to stay in that battle.
Gagner wins the draw with a little help from Taylor Hall. Cross-ice pass intended for Eberle. Didn't work. Eric Nystrom almost sent away. Dubnyk to Nugent Hopkins. 6 minutes to go in regulation time. Here comes Taylor Hall. Hall circles the net. Nugent Hopkins in front. Nugent Hopkins now gets the puck to Gagner on the near side. Sam Gagner. Checked by Nystrom. Eberle in there to try and help out. The puck comes free for Hall. Hall. Justin Schultz down low. Eberle's back up top. Hall feeds it across to Eberle on the near side. Eberle down low. Sam Gagner. Nugent Hopkins back up top. Justin Schultz takes a look. He'll give it to Eberle. Eberle waits. Back to Justin Schultz. Schultz. Here's a one-timer coming from Hall. Didn't get it. Nugent Hopkins centering pass for Gagner. Dylan Hall down and Sam Gagner's going to the penalty box. With 51 seconds to go and the penalty to Eakin. Sam Gagner will go for tripping.
This gets a little too aggressive digging for this loose puck. Nice little play by Hopkins. Going to slip it right into the feet of Gagner. He can't get really a good shot away, but he digs to try and get the puck the second time. And in the process, takes down Dylan. So some heavy action once again around Lehtinen. He denies the Oilers and Dylan draws the penalty.
I believe for the third time in this game, we'll play 4-on-4 hockey. 14:44, the time of the penalty. 51 seconds left to go in Eakin's penalty. And then Dallas will get their third power play of the game.
Number 89 is Sam Gagner. 2 minutes for tripping.
Room for Alekhine. He's with Yakupov. Shot blocked by Aaron Rome. Jeremy Yager picks it up. Sends it around the board. Trying to get it to Daly. Yakupov instead gets it back to Schmid. Schmid takes a bump from Ben. Ben quickly to Yager. He's got Daly with him. Jaromir Jagr to Trevor Daly. Daly back to Yager. Couldn't get the shot away. Good defensive play there by Jeff Petrie. Here comes Yakupov. Trying to get it to Hemsky. Cut off by Ben. Won't go back the other way. Jamie Benn. Jagr. Daly. Daly. Great defensive play. Jagr shot scores. Jaromir Jagr makes it a 3-1 game.
Well, a quick turn of events here and a little turnover in the neutral zone once again, trying to spring Hemsky. Yakupov just can't get very good wood on the backhand pass. As a result, it comes back and looks like it's broken up on a good defensive play to come back. Jaromír Jágr just stays with it. And watch him just follow that puck, quick little turn, picks it up, spinorama. And how many times have we seen this over the course of his career? When he gets in that danger zone, gets a good shot away, such a tough guy to stop. And he beats Devan Dubnyk for a 3-1 lead.
His 669th career goal puts him all alone in 10th place in the National Hockey League. An unassisted marker for Jaromír Jágr at 15:25 has given the Stars a two-goal cushion. And now they've got a power play for the next minute and 7 seconds. Trevor Daly had an assist. His first of the season. Ryder with the puck now. He'll give it to Goligoski. Steps into a slap shot. That one whistles wide. In fact, it gets all the way by Derek Roy. And Roy is going to have to go get it with less than 4 minutes to go. 40 seconds left in the penalty to Sam Gagne. Vierby. He had a shorthanded goal against Columbus. Give and go with Jordan Eberle. Vierby circles the net. Eberle out in front. It comes, trying to get it to Justin Schultz. Too high. Ryder picks it off. Eric Roy. Louis Erickson. To the corner it goes. Potter is there. He'll give it to Eberle. Down to the far side. Magnus Vierby checked by Louis Erickson. Eberle with it now. Sam Gagne ready to get out of the penalty box. Penalty is over. Teams at even strength. 3 minutes. 10 seconds to go in regulation time. The Oilers desperate. They're down by two. Stefan Robidoff. Pass for Garbutt. Too far for him. Nugent Hopkins looking for Hemsky. He knocks down Robidoff. Puck still alive. Nugent Hopkins. Hemsky. Hemsky. Worked over, knocked down by Fiddler, gets the puck out. Garbutt, the race with Schultz. Garbutt cutting for the net, scores! Ryan Garbutt gets his second goal of the season. And it's a 4-1 game.
What a nice power move here by Garbutt. He had Schultz all over him, and a good cross check to him as he was driving it to the net. He has the wherewithal to get it to the forehand and put this puck in an area where he can score. A good defensive play here. And Fiddler gives Hemsky a little bit of a shot from the back. The fans here wanted a penalty on that one. But Garbutt just a good little rush down the ice. Protects the puck well, drives it to the net. As he was going down, gets that shot away. And maybe a little grab of the stick there by him. But a quick, strong move to the forehand and a sharp shot beats Dubnyk.
He did not dress the last time these teams met. An undrafted 27-year-old free agent makes it a 4-1 Stars lead.
The Dallas goal scorer, unassisted by number 40, Ryan Garbutt. Time, 17 minutes.
Bit high.
17 seconds.
17-17, the time of the goal is Potter.
Stars goal,
leads it around the boards. Dallas Stars trying to win their fifth straight game against the Edmonton Oilers. They're 55th in franchise history. Yakupov with a shot. Lettinen, the quick pad save. Rome without his stick. Aaron Rome gets it back again. Plays it to the near side. Corey Potter trying to keep it in, but can't do it. Comes down into Oiler territory. Under 2 minutes left to go. The Oilers have fired 36 shots the way of Kari Lettinen. And just one shot. Taylor Hall has gotten by him. Fister. Petrie quickly up for Hartikainen. He'll dump it in. Ben Eager on his horse. Gets the puck away as Larson heard footsteps. Fiddler on the near side. Fister and Fiddler come together. Second time that has happened. Centering pass for Belanger, picked off by Nystrom. Good job to keep it in by Petrie, but he knocked it down with a high stick.
Hey fans, we've got our 50-50 winner of the season.
Connected is coming up after the game with a preview. Here we go.
Former Edmonton assistant GM Scott Housen is out of a job in Columbus. Doug McClain weighs in.
And Jerome Iginla gets called out by a former teammate.
Ken and Ivanka, thanks very much. Of course, we'll get player interviews, coaches, scrums, and the analysis of this game that has a minute 21 left in it. Of course, the guy's talking about the big news that in Columbus, Lou, we were just there. Scott Housen, former assistant GM here in Edmonton, is out of a job. Mitchell tied up behind the net. Cody Eakin. Nugent Hopkins wanting him. Dallas Stars on their way to their fourth straight win. Back in the day, of course, these two teams, six times they met in the playoffs. The Oilers winning just one of those series, of course, in 1997 when Todd Marchant was the hero in Game 7. Charbonneau looking for Nystrom. Both of those guys have goals in this game. Taylor Hall has the Oilers goal. He's looking for more here. Hall surrounded by white shirts. Nice steal by Eberle. Eberle moving in. Eberle, can he get a shot away? Does! And a penalty coming up, and it's going to be a hooking call. And that was created by Jordan Eberle. And Ryan Garbutt is headed to the penalty box in the too little, too late department.
I'll tell you what, it's not from a lack of effort. It's a little bit of a role reversal. This is what happened in Columbus a couple nights ago. The Edmonton Oilers were holding on and were able to get the win for the Dallas Stars. They faced a lot of firepower from Edmonton. Their goaltender, Lettinen, has pretty much stole this game because there should have been four or five more goals for Edmonton in it. But he's had a strong performance, and the top line of Edmonton has been all over it.
Fifth power play, Lou. But this one is going to go in the books in favor of the Dallas Stars as they come in here and win two straight at Rexall Place. They'll go to Dallas for the final game of the series. That will take place February 28th. But the final in this one reads Dallas 4, Edmonton 1.
Great game by Kari Lettinen tonight. He held his team in this game, stonewalled the Edmonton Oilers after that first one winning. Kept it a close game. Dallas came out and was opportunistic with three goals in the third period to close this one out.
It's in the books. We'll come back to wrap things up from Rexall Place after this brief timeout.